Ça?
Ouvert pas.
Pourquoi ça parle, mon nom?
Ah, ça t'a été arrivé. Vi bara ser nu, vi blir ner.
Vad är klockan då?
17.04, så vi ska ta 17.14.
Så då kommer jag in. Okej? Okay. En, två, tre.
Nej, men du...
Det är jävla röken din.
Nej, men vad gjorde du med lysen då?
Nej, jag gjorde inte något. Du bara såg till det.
Men när du går där så måste du vara väldigt försiktig, för du kommer till dirre.
Ja, men det var ju fullt av rök här, Mats.
Ja, men det får gå.
Det är jävla fett röken din. Okej. Okej, en, två,
och så gå försiktigt.
Ja. Hi everyone, Merry Christmas! This is a Christmas special from Your Way to Norway. And today I have a special guest here. And I'm sorry, it's not Santa Claus. And are you Donald Trump? No. Are you Barack Obama? We have Barack Obama as a Christmas guest! No, I'm just kidding. Ladies and gentlemen, this is your Christmas present from us, Mats Nilsson, the producer and the photographer of Your Way to Norway, my friend and teammates. And today, I've tried to get him in front of the camera before, and today, due to Christmas, he said yes. Hello, Mats.
Hello.
How are you?
Hi all you dear subscribers, I'm just doing this for you because he has forced me to appear on camera.
Yeah.
And I don't see the use for
and
that.
Remember Mats, this is a Christmas joyful special.
Yeah, a happy Christmas, yeah. But I don't see the point why I'm at camera.
But you're my guest and I want to know, and I'm sure you guys also want to know, how is it to celebrate Christmas in Norway? And can I ask you Mats, what do you love most about Christmas in Norway?
I love the fact that you get free from work. You don't have to work. And
how long time do you get free from work?
Oh, this it depends on the weekdays and things like that. This Christmas really stinks because it's very few days off from work. And
only 1 week, I think, actually.
It's just 1 week. But if you're lucky, it's 2 weeks. But in Norway, it's like if you have some days, if you have free for Monday, Tuesday, and you are going to work on Wednesday, we call it inneklemte dager.
Yeah. So.
And then you can then nobody expect you to be at work. So, yeah. But this Christmas is just 1 week. So.
So, but you love that you don't have to work in Christmas. Are there other things that you love with Christmas in Norway?
No.
Yes. What do you do on Christmas Day?
Oh, okay. I like one thing.
Okay, what's that?
I like to go, I can't exclude anyone, but I love the fact that I'm seeing cool family members on one occasion, and we are gathered on a big party, and it's a lot of alcohol and playing old games and stuff like that, and it's very chill and you can be yourself. That's cool. But
so you love spending time with your family at Christmas?
Some family.
Okay, some family.
Yeah.
Okay. Do you want to be more specific, or no, maybe no, the families are watching.
Maybe the family is watching.
Okay.
No, I some Christmas parties are really cool, but some Christmas parties are just duty. You know, it's you have to attend. And when are we speaking about what we hate?
No. But listen, I mean, we have a lot of subscribers and a lot of viewers from the rest of the world, and how would you characterize Christmas in Norway? What are we doing as a nation, as a culture, as people?
In Norway, it's all.
When does it start, for instance?
In Norway, the Christmas starts like late September. Then all the shops start to push out Christmas stuff, and actually, it could start in early January actually, because we have imported a lot of American traditions into Norway. So we have Black Friday, Halloween.
But that's
so what? Yeah. So the whole autumn or the whole fall is like a rush from Halloween to Black Friday to all kind of celebrating.
Yep.
And then you have Christmas, and people are really struggling at Christmas. If you are born with to, if you are.
I wasn't asking you about problem. We're coming back to problems later. You are so angry. Listen, it's supposed to be joyful.
But you forced me here.
Yeah. But let's say it starts in what we call Advent, which is from
the first Sunday in December. It's the first of Advent.
Yeah.
And then we should have some candlelights. And yeah, we have some really expensive candlelights from IKEA, because we are sitting in my apartment, which is an IKEA apartment.
Yeah.
And then the first Sunday in Advent, we are firing one candle, and we say something very Christian. We fire one light today for hope and for joy, and then all of a sudden we do all religious stuff.
Yeah.
And we try
but
to
But is
leave.
Christmas in Norway a religious tradition, or is it people, secular?
People just love traditions in Norway. People just love to They go to church for the first time, and they want to
see... And the only time during
the
year.
And they want to see, it's called Sølvguttene. It's a choir. It's
the Silver Boys.
The Silver Boys is a very famous...
A choir, yeah.
It's a famous choir, and they start singing the Christmas in...
Joyful Christmas! Like this?
Yeah, like this. And the TV, that's a very important stuff, because we are watching the same TV shows over and over and over again.
On repeat.
Yeah, and we have a very old, stupid story about
The contest and the waiter.
Yeah, the contest and the waiter. I think it's more like 200 years old. It was invented before even movies.
It was made in the 60s. Yeah,
and he's getting more and more drunk. And If the public broadcaster doesn't broadcast that in Christmas, it will be a strike all over the country.
And I also think we have a Disney.
And we have to watch Donald Duck. Donald Duck. It's the only time Donald Duck was allowed to be broadcasted by the public broadcaster.
And in Norway, we have the Christmas Eve is the 24th of December. I know some of you guys, you have it in the morning in 25th. I think it has something to do with Catholics or Protestant. But we have it on Christmas Eve.
We are opening our Christmas presents. The night of the 24th, but I think England they opened the day after.
Okay, so but that was. Are there any other things that you would say is typical Norwegian Christmas? Do you have Christmas trees?
Oh yeah, we have a lot of Christmas trees, and we love. We Norwegians, we actually love having the same discussion going on each year. It's like watching the same movies, because we discuss Christmas trees, and you have two kind of Christmas trees. You have pines, and you have another kind, upper class.
We have only 3 minutes.
we love to discuss, shall we have that kind of wood or that kind of tree?
Plastic has become more and more popular.
Yeah, plastic is popular, but we like to discuss it as we do.
I saw here. What do you guys have here? I think you have chosen some plastic stuff, actually. So he loves plastic.
We love plastic. Yeah. But people, most of the people don't. They go to big markets and they buy a juletre. It's a Christmas tree. And
But you know, actually, yes, they do. But before, it used to be only natural. Now it's more and more plastic, I have to say. More and more, all over the place. People are buying into plastic. I think it's a bit sad, but it's true.
Okay, and we also have another recurrent discussion. And that's about the food. And we should Google translate the food before
we
started on it.
Yeah, what is typical Christmas food in Norway,
Mats? Yeah, because we eat, I don't... know the English word, but in Norwegian it's ribbe. I think it's a pork rib.
Pork rib, yeah.
Yeah, pork rib.
Very fatty.
And that's, yeah, it's very fatty. You have to drink a lot of very strong alcohol to show
it. A Norwegian speciality called akavit. Each Christmas you drink that to the fatty
food, yeah. And you eat a lot, The people in Norway, they tend to gain 10 kilos in weight.
But I think that's all over the world. But is it only pig rib?
No, they also eat, and that's another discussion. We love to have that discussion, because we have, I think it's more or less like three different Christmas meals. It's fish, cod, and it's pinnekjøtt, and that's more like spare ribs in a way, but from sheep.
An old sheep.
Yeah.
And it's also the rib. Why are we so fascinated with the animal ribs?
And that's even more fat than the pork. It's so fucking fat.
And I grew up in a sheep, how do you say, on a sheep farm, and each morning I had to take out the urine and the all the other things. And this pinnekjøtt, sheep rib, each year when they make it and I smell it, it's like being on that farm again doing that work.
I really hate it. Yeah, but we love that discussion. Oh, are you a ribbe fan, or are you a pinnekjøtt fan, or are you a cod fan?
I'm a cod fan.
And that can
lead you to... are?
I'm a ribbe fan.
And I am a cod fan.
Yeah, but
and we also have actually another speciality in Christmas. You don't eat it at Christmas Eve, but it's called smala hove, which actually is a sheep's head with eyes and lips and tongues and everything.
And we also,
have you tried it?
I've seen it.
You have seen it, but you haven't tried. Why haven't you tried it?
No, why do I need to eat that?
It's very exotic.
And you also have lutefisk.
Yeah.
And lutefisk, that's a big tradition. You don't eat it at Christmas Eve, but you eat it. We have a lot of, you know, like gatherings.
From the first of December up to 24.
And then you eat lutefisk, and that's actually a fish. It's buried in acid, or some kind of acid, it's really, the ingredients are... poisonous, really poisonous, and it looks grey, and you put it in some...
And it has a jelly substance,
it doesn't look good. Jelly. But that's the Norwegian mentality, you have to suffer before you can be happy.
True.
So that's...
Okay, so I sensed that you were a bit angry towards Christmas, Mats. What do you hate about Christmas in Norway?
Oh, where shall I start? I hate the fact that you're supposed to have a holiday, but on that holiday, it's so many things you have to do, so it's not a holiday. You are forced to meet up with your family, you are forced to go...
Hey, Max, forced? Isn't it lovely to hang around with your family?
Family, it's Christmas time. And you have to meet up at certain times, at 5 o'clock we are going there, and I have to meet my twin brother, and we don't speak the whole year, and all of a sudden we are really, oh no, we're going to my mom's place, and we have to talk about, like, everything is so fucking...
it's family. He's complaining because he has to stay with his family for one day during the year.
No, 3 days.
Okay, 3 days. Oh, I'm so sorry. It is a pain in the ass. I understand. 3 days with family. Is that so bad, Mats?
No, it's okay when akavita and things come... is brought to the table, but... Norwegians are not good at speaking about feelings, and... those Christmas parties can actually go overboard sometimes because family members are drinking too much. And the first 2 hours we talk about the ribbe. Oh, the ribbe, it has a layer of baconish surface on top. And we discuss, oh, the bacon, was it crispy enough? And we can sit and discuss that, and totally uninteresting facts for 2 hours. And then you drink more and more to keep up to stay.
And suddenly someone gives a comment.
It's a fire starter. People talk about heritage and old family problems and issues from long before. And I tell my twin brother that our childhood was actually quite complex. And he says, no, it wasn't. It was perfect. And then it ends in fighting
and shouting and So okay, so that you hate about Christmas, are there other things?
Yeah, julebord.
Okay, julebord. Christmas party.
Okay, this year. I have to reveal one thing, and it's
It's a Christmas party at work.
It sounds very picturesque. If I tell you about the concept.
No, but you don't have time, actually, Mats, because we are...
Yeah, okay, very fast. But this year, my workplace, they were taking us up to a cabin to celebrate Christmas
outside.
Party.
Yeah. We had to drive bus for an hour into the
group. It was like no exit possibilities because you had to go by a bus. It was set up by our workplace.
Yeah.
And it was the only chance to get from there was to have skis on your legs and go for 2 hours. So you were captured there for, and Norwegian loves to go on cabins and gatherings.
So this year, to make a long story short, you skipped the traditional Christmas party at work.
I'm a very bad Norwegian. I'm not a very typical Norwegian.
No, me neither. Well, if I'm gonna say what I hate about Christmas is that some of the things Mats has said, but I don't have so much family, so for me it's, the family stuff is not, I only meet my mother, and I think that is very nice, so that's not a big issue for me. But I think that it's close, you know, even though we are not so religious in Norway, the shops and the city is closed for, let's say, 3-4 days.
Yeah.
And that's really, really boring, because when you have days off, you want to walk in the city and so on, but everything is closed. It's almost that you cannot go to a restaurant.
The city is dead. Yeah. Except from the gay places, they are open. Because the gay have no families to take care of. They go out on Christmas Eve and drink a lot and stuff like that. And I always tend to lose my Visa card and my telephone during that. It's a very holy holiday, so everything is closed. So if you lose your Visa card the first day after Christmas, then you have to wait
and you have to borrow money and you don't have a phone and so on.
Yeah.
Okay, so have we forgotten anything about what is a typical Norwegian Christmas? What I can say is that one thing is
we like to live in that illusion of the white Christmas, Coca-Cola is coming to town. We're very inflated by it.
Absolutely, the American Santa Claus, the whole
American
image.
And we think we are maybe more or less the country of Santa Claus, and we so close it. And
it's Finland.
But we dream about white Christmas. And it's never white.
But that's not true, Mats. In Oslo, where we are now, sometimes it's white, sometimes it's not. I hope it's not, because I don't like snow and I am not dreaming about a white Christmas. But in other Norway, for instance, or in other parts of Norway, it's definitely white Christmas. I've seen they have more than a...
Yeah, they have. Yeah. But we like to just keep up with the appearances, actually. We try to lull ourselves into like a concept.
And we spend... Insanely when it comes to gifts, to food, to drinks and everything. I mean, Christmas is a spending
everyone
spree.
Everyone is bankrupt after...
Yeah, absolutely.
Actually, I'm not special for Norway. We got half taxes in the month before Christmas because we shall be able to spend.
That's really...
That's unique for Norway.
It's people are really, really buying, spending money, and it's a kids' party act. As most of the things in Norway, it's centered around kids. So kids, they get like 1,000 gifts each, and expensive gifts, and that is very, very typical of Norway. And each time the government, the financial counselor, they are out there in the news media saying, oh, please don't use your credit card, don't take up loans because of Christmas, because that's a huge problem. So that is very typical Norway. It's very expensive.
And I think we can go out of this video with a little visual take on what I think about Christmas.
I think this is the
jingle
end of the
bells, jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle.
You know, if you like what you
we,
see.
No, we haven't talked about Christmas songs. They're all Christian. They're very Christian.
No. But yeah, most of them actually are American. We have the, we have many of them.
Okay. Yeah. And this is Happy Christmas.
But do you have a vacuum cleaner? No. It's plastic.
Christmas.
Okay,
joyful Christmas.
Have a joyful Christmas.
It was very hard
we
to
see. We love
in front
you
of
guys, really we do. And this
I don't
is for
see,
you.
I don't see any use for this video, but please you have to share.
I hope you enjoyed to see Mats. Please let us know if you think that Mats should be in front of the camera often. Tell us what you thought about this episode, because he's very skeptical. He thinks this is stupid. Why should he be in front of the camera? You guys are not interested in us. You are interested in to learn more about Norway. So can you please not subscribe and let us know what you think about him in front of camera.
Yeah, and we also have a Facebook page. You should check
of
that
course,
out.
Of course.
I update that with facts about Norway all the time.
And maybe we should end with a Christmas song. Do you know Musevisa?
No, I don't know
Musevisa. Men høysingen går i fella, men passer seg for den. Så alle sammen handler seg jule igjen. Heisan og hoppsan og faller allera. Så julekvelden kommer da vi alle sammen glad. Heisan og hoppsan og faller allera. Når julekvelden
går i fella, så skal det bli veldig bra.
Yeah, bye bye.
See you next time.
Yeah. That's what you're right there. Yeah. Vi satt i kanskje 20 minutter.
Vent da, da kan vi bare legge 20 minutter.